I'm so cut, like, really, I'm so cut. I'm so cut up from not getting a Valentine's Day card that I'm just so cut. Hi everyone, hope you're having a great day and doing whatever you're doing. So I am going to be doing the, do slashes down the sides of your face, and it'd be just looking like someone just came along with a razor and went for some reason unknown. I don't know. Anyway, so, I have already primed my face, and I've actually got normal every day-to-day makeup on. I'm sorry for the lighting, it's so shy, I know, I'm so sorry, but it's what I got to work with tonight. I don't know, because I'm working tonight, because I've had a lot of stuff on of late, so yeah, I have to work kind of around that at the moment, so, plus I'm very, very sick, so yeah, that too. So here's my everyday makeup. It's just, as a regular, you know, mascara and whatever. You can have normal face for this. I'm just putting on my normal makeup so that it'll go with, like, blending in the sides as well, because when I put when you're putting, like, look like your skin is peeling off with the cuts in your face, you need to actually add foundation things to it, so that's what you have to do. So you start off, we have to add tears to our face, and in order to do that I'm going to be using tissue. So it's a bit weird because we call our skin tissue, you see, and I think it's a bit weird, and the fact that I have to use tissue to simulate skin slash tissue, which is really strange. So I'm just getting this tissue and tearing it into the layers. So I'm pulling it apart because some tissues have 3 or 4 layers, and I buy the aloe kind, so I buy the one with lots and lots of layers, so it's like 3 layers to it and lots of moisturizer on it, which is good because it stops my nose from hurting because I'm sick. So here we go. Okay, so you have to get it and then you have to tear it up, tear bits up, just tear it up. And the reason we're tearing this up is so that we can get pieces like this, like, see, so it's both edges are torn. You can see if I can, yeah, so you can see both edges are torn, so that when you stick it on, it's not just, you know, skin on skin, you'll have like rough bits hanging from your face, so that we want that effect. So yeah, so you just get pieces like that, and you get to, you'll tear bits off where you don't need it, but you just make it like this, so that, you know, you at least have some of these. So just start tearing it up and I'll be back in a tick. Okay, so I've torn all this tissue up, see all this tissue, torn it all up, ready to go. So I've got my strips ready and I have latex, see, some latex here, good. But first, you have to mark out where and how long you want to put it. So you need like a guideline to know where to put the strips, otherwise you're a bit like myself. So I'm using just the pencil, okay, the eyeline and eyebrow pencil, just to mark it out. So for a surprise, I'm gonna make one super gory and one super beautiful on the other side. Okay, so it's a 2-for-1. You're getting a gore session and an oh my god session. So here we go. So yeah. So here's my 2 big gashes right here. So now I've done that, I've marked them out. The next point is that I'm going to start sticking all the tissues onto my face. So I'm going to need like a little palette thing I always stick some latex onto, and you've got to be quick because otherwise it dries very quick. So I'm going to put it in my palette sort of thing. I've just dropped some latex, that's going to go great. You've got to watch out with latex because it can get very rubbery and very hard very quick. So you got to be careful, be very, very careful. It gets gluey very quick. So you have to sort of be careful and get an earbud. Don't ever use a paintbrush unless you don't want to use that paintbrush ever again. Okay, and I'll see you guys on the other side of this, I suppose. Here we go. Like I've got like paper beads, which is really strange, which is not exactly what I've got here. Okay, so I've chucked all this on with latex, okay, so that it's stuck to my face. And you really need to prime your face or have something underneath it, because when you take off the latex you need like a barrier, like a non-oily barrier between this like makeup. Like if you put on regular makeup, like all day makeup, that would be better, because that way you've got some sort of barrier between latex and your skin, because latex on skin, pulling it off is like exactly like pulling off a band-aid, so you don't want that. So this is just regular stuff, because I've had that before where I've just put latex on skin and it feels like I just shaved and it wasn't very pretty and it hurt. So be careful and actually use proper, like, this is like professional latex. Stuff. There's quality latex. It's proper latex, and I use it for my face, so it's not just art latex or whatever. It's like makeup quality. So it's gonna fix where grease is at. I'm gonna let these dry. So I'll come back when these are all dry. Okay, so the latex is dried, and I've torn all the tissue. See, you can see the line I made. This is what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to show you that you can see the lines that I made on my face, which is I want that to come through so that you can see that you've got the gap in between, but then you've also got the tissue. And I started to try to dig a part of my tissue and tear a little bit of it up, not so much. Just make it look so, you know, later on when you paint it in, it'll look scabby and look gross. So you're trying to peel up some of the tissue, because this will just look like, you know, someone tore up your skin. So you're starting to see now, get closer, starting to see now that is the case. Okay, so now I've got to go in with some actual like foundation, so that matches in with my skin. So whatever color skin that you have, like regular foundation, if you're a girl, just your regular foundation is fine. If you're a guy, get a girl to help you pick out foundation. If you wear makeup already and you're a guy, that's fine. You know what you're doing. If you're a guy who doesn't know makeup, get a girl to do it. So this is like my regular color that I'm going to use, just regular foundation. So I'm just going to get my foundation brush that I usually use on my face. Find it, and I'm just gonna get it and pour a little bit of my foundation in here like I always do, because I use lids instead of using like palettes like I should, but you know, whatever. Okay, and so I'm just gonna paint this into my face and paint the tissue, like the outer tissue, not the inner tissue, just the outer tissue into my face, so that it looks like part of my face. That it needs to be skin colored, on the outer part of your face. So maybe the ends as well, the ends. Okay, the ends of your face. So the ends. Painting the edges of your face. Paint them in. Blend them in, at least blend it in as part of your face. And I'll have to go in with my regular routine as well. Okay, see you on the other side of this. Okay, so I blended in my regular makeup to go with this. Some of the skin is pulling up, but that's okay. It just adds to the effect. So I added like my regular like blush and my regular bronzer that I use on my face. So yeah, that you can see. So I use those two regular things so that it would blend in with my face, which you can see on this one it has. On this one not so much because all of the skin's lifting up, but that's okay. So the next part we want to add is the gore. We need to add the gore. So I've got my blood here. This is my fake blood that I own. I use a lot for paint, and now I've got red paint, so I don't. I've also got some black paint, because sometimes if you mix black paint with a little bit of the blood, it makes it look a bit more yucky and more congealed. Also, I've got me some spray paint, which is spray blood. This is a bottle of blood. Not real blood, fake blood. And if I spray it on my face, it has one little jet, so it jets on my face and lets it run down my face. Makes it look like there is blood pouring from my face, which is really, really cool. So I get to show you this for the first time. I'm excited because I love this. Anyway, so yeah, I'm gonna start trying to paint that in. I'm gonna use an e-bud to paint it in. So see you on the other side of this with my fake blood. Put blood around this one. I'm gonna put some of this darker blood actually around this one as well, so it looks a bit gory, because in between I'm gonna paint like silver in here to make it look like I'm actually silver in under there. But I need to have this darker blood put on to make it look different. Okay, so put silver in there to make it look like I bleed silver, not just blood. And on this side I'm going to make it look all super gory, which already it is starting to look super gory, but I'm just adding splotches of, I've got blood and black that I was mixing together. So this is black face paint and blood, that fake blood I've blooded in and make it look all super yucky, which is what I'm so it looks all yuck right there. But I'm also gonna add some yellow, which I have here somewhere. So I just got some yellow face paint. Just gonna get some yellow face paint and sort of dot it around the edge here as well. Make it look kind of scabby and yuck, which is a great effect. And it mixes in with the blood. As soon as I put it in, it mixes like the blood, so it kind of looks kind of pussy. That's what the yellow is about, the pussy looking sore, which is great. And what I do is I add pus with some yellow and some white. I got some white face paint. So it's kind of like a palette, you know, like an art palette, like you're adding so much color and depth. Okay. Some white paint here as well. So I got white happening. Paint here. And then I'll get the dark blood sort of look here. Blood. Here we go. And that mixes in with what I'm doing. It just makes the gash look a lot more creamier, a lot more grosser. So someone's really smashed and hacked into my face. Comes out looking amazing. Looks very chunky. Very gross. And I'll just quickly go around this one as well. I'm trying to add a little bit more drama to this side, like it's all bloody and yuck, which is what I'm trying to add. So that slashy effect. Okay, so now that's gonna be there, I've gotta wait for this to dry before I can do anything else. Awesome. I forgot to mention that while I was waiting for this to dry, that I can add this, my fake blood spray, which you guys have seen but never seen in action. So this is the first time you'll see my blood spray in action, which is super awesome. So you're about to. So make sure you have a bib or something underneath, because this can get quite messy. So what I'm going to do is I've got a tissue right here ready to catch all the droplets. So I'm about to spray it on here. Wish me luck. Here we go. Plausible for blood. So you can have blood spatter, you can have it up close, far away. I chose far away to get this effect, make it look like it's more gory and it actually happened. So there it is. Okay, I gotta let this dry, so see you on the flip side. Okay, so this is drying on this side here. And seeing all the drips from the blood spray come out, really, really good. So it's always good to have blood spray. That doesn't come out as like a spray, as in like spray. It comes out in a little jet so that it looks like you've actually got blood running down your face, which I think is pretty cool, because you can't do it otherwise. You can't just drop it and let it go because it's a different type of pattern. So I'm really impressed with this. And it really looks like someone really fucked up my face. So I am so happy with this side. So I'm really finished this side now. So it really looks like someone hacked into my face. And this side here, I'm adding silver here. This silver that I've used before on my palette here. And I'm going to try and put this into this here to make me look more fabulous. Try and put silver in with a little brush. Just a little standard brush that I own. So, try and wash that in. I don't know if this works, but I've seen it before on Google, and I thought, oh, that looks interesting. I want to try it. So I'm going to see if it'll make it look like someone's cut into my face, but underneath I'm silver. Kind of like a silver surfer. My silver surfer chick underneath. Who knew? Surfer underneath, which I think is cool. This is like the only glittery sort of metallic makeup I own. I saw some the other day at the makeup shop and I thought, but I'm not getting any. Special effects makeup shop. They've got everything. Silver. I just started to undermine the one bit, like I'm a metallic robot underneath. And the other side, I'm just gory and gross. So I'm super happy with that. Like, I can't be any happier because my skin looks like it's lifting, which is great. Like, the tissue on the outside looks like the skin is lifting off, which is what the effect is going to be. Lightly, not a whole lot, because I don't want to ruin the effect of, like, I'm trying to overlap some of the silver with some blood, so that you can see that I do have blood, but underneath I do have silver. So I'm kind of like sparkly and fabulous underneath, but I'm also like that, I'm kind of sparkly underneath and pretty underneath, but also gory and gross. So I'm kind of happy with how this looks now. So it's a lot of latex, tissue, fake blood, metallic makeup, and just a normal, regular, day-to-day makeup. So yeah, it's so simple. Do get some of this. I got this from a makeup store. You can also get it from dress-up stores. I know there's some cheap stores out there that sell Halloween makeup all year round. You can get it from there. This is a blood spray. It's a fake blood spray. Amen to this. I love this. If it runs out and I'll never get it again, I'll be very upset. I'll be trying to find a place where they sell it. But this stuff is amazing, and the nozzle that's on it is fantastic. So I do say go out there, get some fake blood spray. It makes your makeup look super real. So it's good stuff. So yeah, this fake blood and everything looks amazing. Looks like I've got cuts in my face, and actually looks like really in my face, and it makes it look really fantastic, and I'm super happy. So yeah, so this is the tutorial how to make you look gory and cut in one face on the other, and then cut in my face like I have either been a robot or I want to be fabulous and I'm silver underneath, which is cool. And you can make the tear bigger and be as big as you want, and you can make it bigger and make it look more metallic by adding nuts and bolts, maybe with the black liner and nuts and bolts, or maybe even make it more fabulous, add glitter or add something more like metallic or different colors, pinks, blues, whatever you want to put in there to make it look more fabulous or sparkly, or make it look like you're a sparkly demon robot underneath, or whatever you like. And I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope everyone likes it and enjoys it and as much as I did, and especially the fake blood. And I'll see you guys next time, and bye.